usual, we'll begin our journey by writing down the number 3.5 times 10 to the 15th. The unit was grams, and the label was C8H18. This number was the given. We'll set up our three conversion factors. We know that it takes three steps to move all the way from the left to the right-hand side of our stoichiometry roadmap. Given a mass, we want to calculate a mass going to grams of carbon dioxide. Moving from given to what we want, in the heart of our problem, the want over given stoichiometric ratio coming from our balanced coefficients. Given a gram unit, we need to work it into the mole. Coefficients stand for mole numbers, not mass ratios, so we have a little mole map work to do. To convert a mass into a mole, we're going to need the molar mass of our compound. Carbon has an atomic weight of 12, but there's 8 of them, so I'll go 12 times 8 to represent the weight of carbon, plus 18 times 1, the weight of hydrogen. Weight of hydrogen being 1, but there's 18 of them. The total weight of C8H18 is 114 grams. Here's what we know. Every 1 mole of C8H18 would have a molar mass of 114 grams. That cancels the mass unit grams and brings us into the mole. We're ready for the ratio, our want over given. We want to know carbon dioxide. Its coefficient is a 16. Given the ratio of octane as a 2. By setting up our want over given ratio, we've now canceled the mole unit for octane. One more step, and that's to exchange the mole unit into the mass. So we'll need a molar mass of what we want. That would be the carbon dioxide. Carbon, again, with a molar mass of 12, and 16 times 2 to represent the two oxygens for a total weight of 44. So in the last parenthesis, 44 grams of carbon dioxide for every 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Moles of CO2 have canceled. Divide, ratio, multiply. The three steps to stoichiometry. Step 1, divide by molar mass of given. Step 2 is the stoichiometric ratio from the coefficients, want over given. Step 3, we multiply by the molar mass of what we want. And let's hit that together. On our calculator, start by typing 3.5 e to the 15th. That's red on our screen is 3.5 times 10 to the 15th power. We do not hit times 10 to the caret key. We use the scientific notation key. 3.5 times 10 to the 15th looks like this on your screen, 3.5 e 15. We'll divide by 114, the molar mass of octane, times 16 over 2 for the ratio, and times 44 to bring it out to grams of CO2. Our final answer, 1.08 times 10 to the 16th power grams of carbon dioxide. We burned a whole lot of gasoline, and it looks like we produced even more carbon dioxide. Your book will chat about contributing to the greenhouse effect and global warming as an after effect of burning gasoline. Given a mass, calculate a mass, the three steps to stoichiometry. Our text provides us with one more example. How many grams of glucose can be synthesized from 37.8 grams of carbon dioxide in photosynthesis? Referring back to the previous slide, the front direction we called respiration. If I read the same equation but in reverse, we get what's called photosynthesis. So let's rewrite our balanced equation in the opposite direction. 6 moles of carbon dioxide react with 6 moles of water to form 1 glucose molecule and 6 moles of of oxygen. The process of photosynthesis is the reverse of respiration. It would like us to calculate how many grams of glucose can be made if I started with 37.8 grams of carbon dioxide. Our given is a mass of CO2. What we want is the mass of glucose. Given a mass, calculate a mass, the three steps to stoichiometry. We will begin, as always, by writing down the number 37.8. The unit is a gram and the label is CO2. Moving from a mass to a mass involves the three steps to stoichiometry, where we divide, ratio, multiply. We'd like to move it from grams of CO2 to grams of glucose, C6H12O6. This is our want. Over here is our given. And let's go to work. Every 1 mole of carbon dioxide had a molar mass of 44 grams. I know that just from a moment ago, we counted that up. Carbon with 12, 32, 12 plus 32 gave me the 44. I just added that a moment ago. Our heart of our problem, we want to know glucose. Its coefficient is a 1, so C6H12O6 gets placed on the top using its coefficient of 1. Starting from the carbon dioxide and its coefficient of 6. Here's what we've managed to do. In our first step, we canceled grams of CO2. We then canceled moles of CO2, and now one last step to convert moles of sugar into grams of sugar. And that involves a molar mass of what we want. Carbon with a weight of 12, but there's 6 of them. Hydrogen has a weight of 1, and there's 12 of them in the formula, plus 16 times 6 for the oxygen. 6 carbons at 12 apiece, 12 hydrogens at 1 apiece, and 6 oxygens that weigh 16 apiece. Those are being pulled from the periodic table, looking up their atomic weights. The molar mass of this compound is 180. 180 grams of glucose for every 1 mole of glucose. And what this last step has enabled us to do is to cancel the moles and bring it out to grams. Last thing we'll do is hit and find our answer. 37.8 divided by 44 divided by 6 times 180. 37.8 times 1 over 44 times 1 over 6 times 180 over 1. And when I hit that out, I find a screen that says 25.77 grams of glucose. Make sure you take a moment and hit this out and see if we reach a common answer. I'll stop the video here. We'll be ready to move on.